Episode 2332, Love Takes Time.
It's time to train for life and love your journey. In this episode of Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, you'll learn new ways to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew your mind, body, and spirit. Please welcome your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo.
Staring at a stop sign, watching people drive by.
Happy, happy day as we celebrate this beautiful Memorial Weekend and we honor our veterans and our military, those who serve in blue. Thank you so much for your service, families, for you supporting them. We love you. We appreciate you. Today is Relationship Builders Day. And what better way to celebrate Memorial Weekend than really looking at how we honor our own relationships, especially in our marriage. Love takes time. For those of you who are brand new to Create You Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com where you can learn more and sign up for the Kisses newsletter, the Keep It Simple strategy, everyday solutions to live, love, and impact. Well, this episode is brought to you by the AIM Academy. You know, I want to put in a really quick plug here. Believe it or not, I have a second book out. I'm a co-author along with a few many other authors, but we have a book out called One Habit, The World's Greatest Leaders. And it's really looking at different people's perspectives. There's 69 authors, and it's just an incredible compilation of what we can do to impact the world that we can touch one habit at a time. So you may want to pick up your own copy and you can learn from people from around the globe. Well, let's dive in today. If love was just a chemical attraction, it would be love at first sight. But why rush something of greatness? Love takes time. As I was lying with my husband reflecting over the day, I asked him if he had a headliner for my episode today. It was one of those questions like, oh, my brain's fried. I really need some other people thinking for me. And believe it or not, he actually said yes. I was stunned. I was surprised as this was late at night and he usually checks out early when it comes to deep thinking. I mean, he works hard all day long, has to really work those brain cells. And the last thing he wants to do is make more decisions, really put himself in a position of, you know, helping more people. Not that he doesn't want that to happen, but he does it all day and to come home and he has his wife asking him, hey, do you have anything? But I was really intrigued. So I asked more questions, of course. He continued to say how many refer to love at first sight as that deep infatuation with someone. But that's really the meaning of it. A lot of people say, oh, well, you know, it was just love at first sight. It was just one of those things. But it's truly a chemical reaction that draws you near each other with the end intention of a physical encounter. That is love at first sight. It's chemical. However, true love comes over time. Yes, you can have that love at first sight, that initial wow factor. But in order to love someone, you have to get to know them over time and see their heart, who they are from the inside out. But what happens is that life gets complicated. And whether or not you're just dating now, or maybe you're in a committed relationship, we want to live with what feels good, but those feelings can be a distraction, right? Temptations lie. Don't make permanent decisions with temporary feelings. That is your Kiss the Keep It Simple strategy. Don't make permanent decisions with temporary feelings. When the going gets tough in marriage, don't rely solely on the feelings because those feelings can lead you astray and put you in a position that you later regret or question how you got there. Now, understand this. Our conversation with my husband and I, it was not about the whole idea of, oh, wait, we're in a committed relationship, hun, and oh, you know, love at first sight. Maybe I see someone from afar. We're not talking just about affairs here. In fact, that's not even the topic of conversation. Truly what it is about love, the foundation of love, and how you build that in a relationship. And a lot of us just think that, oh my gosh, we have to connect. But it's not about the chemical connection. It's about the holistic connection. It's knowing the mind, heart, body, and soul, the spirit of the person that's before you. And this love foundation, this relationship that you're building, it can be talking about your best friend. It can be talking about in a committed relationship with your spouse. It can be talking about your relationship with your child or a relationship that you're mentoring in your community or church. So understand that this is not tunnel vision, because I know our minds are short like that. And you might be thinking, oh, well, we're talking about, you know, marriage and affairs. No, we're not. We're talking about the basic foundation of love. And how is that built? It's built over time. It's not about love at first sight. So how do you begin to really build that love foundation within your relationship? Well, number one, distinguish between facts and feelings. This is where you focus on the no good, the K-N-O-W, versus the feel good. We got to look at the truth versus the, oh, this is kind of what I like right now. Because the grass is greener on the other side can always lead us astray. And most of the time, that's called reactions. We need to deal with responses. We need to know good, K-N-O-W. We know the truth. We need to know the facts. And we've got to sometimes, yes, believe it or not, lay aside the feelings. Because if you sit here and only deal with your relationship on feelings, do you think that's going to really get you to where you want to go? No. Because I don't know about you, but I bet you your spouse has already kind of irritated you today. It doesn't have to be this like big blowout, but it could be like, oh my gosh, there are his shoes again. Why can't he put them away? And you may think it, you may not even say it, but guess what's attached to that thought? Feelings. And if we lead our everyday with just our feelings and not our facts, do you think there's any way of building a strong foundation? No. So you got to distinguish between the facts and feelings. Number two, double down on your values. If what you quickly see as a way out, does it support your values? If it does not, then you better think about taking a step back. When you look at affairs, when you look at this, oh my gosh, the grass is greener on the other side. And it doesn't matter if you're in a committed marriage or you're not married, but you're in a committed relationship. You need to set values, and those values create boundaries. And when you begin to start looking beyond those values and you begin to cross the lines, that's a good indication that you need to take a step back. And it's also a good indication that you need to refer back to one. Are you distinguishing between the facts and the feelings? Love is not just about chemicals. Love is about knowing the heart, knowing the mind. One thing I have so enjoyed is getting to know my husband, because you know what? He changes and he's growing every single day. And it warms my heart, because I see the intention that he puts in to our marriage, our relationship, which then overflows into our relationship with our children, which then overflows into the relationship with our community and church and his job and his colleagues, my relationship with you all. It expands, and pretty soon, what do you have here? A huge ocean. It's attractive. It's magnetic. But you got to be careful. If you're only looking at the feelings, you got to double down on your values. And finally, number three, dedicate your heart to take risks. Work beyond what is easy. Don't throw in the towel because you're finished. You know, yeah, the shoes are still out. Guess what? Is it really a good reason to have that adult temper tantrum? Because, oh my goodness, this is like 150 times this week that you've seen those shoes out, and that's not an exaggeration? No. Take a step back, understand the challenge, and be intentional with your actions. Take aim on what matters. You got to take and dedicate your heart to take the risks. And if you're not willing to do that, then are you really putting in the work that your relationship deserves? I know I ask these hard questions because I ask them of myself. And no, I don't sit around every day sitting here having these deep thoughts every moment, but there have been seasons in my life that, yes, every day I was reflecting on hard questions, searching for hard answers, really figuring out, is it just feelings or is it facts? How does it interact and correlate with my values? Where do they cross? Do my values support the boundaries that I have? And are they right? And some people would say, well, I don't know how to do that. Well, you know what? We could be here all year long talking about that. And that's one of the reasons why we have AIM. The AIM Academy is going to be opening up soon. You're going to want to be there. We take so many things for granted. We take the person who we sleep with for granted. And sometimes what happens is there's a drastic shift. There's something that is stirred up in life. And you didn't see it coming. And then you wish you would have not taken for granted the person who's next to you. Don't make permanent decisions based on temporary feelings. Don't be quick to judge. Be quick to understand. Be quick to listen. Be slow to speak. When it comes to saying, this is how I feel all the time. And guess what? I am right! ! That's going to get you into trouble in the long run. And yes, there is give and take. You have to have compromise with compassion. And with compassion, you have to have compromise. You have to be willing to lead, but you also have to be willing to follow. My husband laughs at me and he goes, I don't understand you, Christiane. He said, it's, you know, heavy, but it's light. And I'm like, exactly. And he goes, but that doesn't make sense. It's like opposites. I said, I know, but it's true. It's the dichotomy. And it works so well together. Building a relationship on a strong foundation of love takes intention. I promise you, love is worth the work. And you know, love takes time. Go out today and be sure to express your appreciation for those who serve your community and your country. For that, I am very grateful. Go out, be present, be incredible, be you. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a glorious weekend. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.